Is this the next revolution in 3D printing nozzles? Bontech's CHT nozzles have a totally unique design where your filament gets split up into three individual strands to significantly improve melting performance. Does this render volcano hot ends obsolete? I've taken a closer look at the new design and tested its performance, print quality, and even cut one open to take a look on the inside. Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Squarespace is one of the easiest yet beautiful website development tools out there. I've been using Squarespace for several years for my own website and can truly say that it didn't only help me to create a beautiful web presence, but makes it also super easy to maintain. Adding new pages and articles is quick and simple, which is why I always provide additional content to my videos there. If you have a business, are an artist or a tinkerer, you need a website and Squarespace is probably the best place to make one. Choose one of the beautiful templates as a starting point and then customize it to your needs with no web design knowledge required. If you're still getting stuck, contact their 24/7 365-day support or check out their great help center available in several different languages. Support the channel and try it out yourself with a free trial at squarespace.com/cnckitchen and get 10% off your first website or domain purchase if you use code cnckitchen at your checkout. Regular 3D printing nozzles look all pretty much the same on the inside. There's one drilled hole that's slightly bigger than your filament diameter that goes almost all the way down to the tip, at which point the small orifice bore starts that defines your nozzle diameter. There's some slight variation, with the cheapest ones just drilled with a standard 118 degrees drill tip. E3D tried to improve on that many years ago with a step bore, probably to improve internal flow, but now uses, as many other higher quality manufacturers, a special drill bit with a pointier tip for better flow characteristics. Ultimaker still uses a special step geometry in their AA print cores, maybe for less oozing during retracts. So these are all just slight variations of a simple design. This right here is Bontech's new CHT nozzle that features a special core that splits up your filament into three separate channels. CHT means core heating technology, which means that the material is not only melted from the outside in, but also from the inside out, promising higher melt rates. Bontech is actually not the one who came up with this idea. Maybe you have already seen the matchless nozzles from 3D Solex that have been around for a while, though never been particularly popular. Bontech has now licensed the core heating technology and made their own version of it. They licensed it because it's unfortunately patented by 3D Solex, but I'll get to that later. The CHT nozzles are a drop-in replacement for your standard E3D and RepRap nozzles with an M6 thread, so you can even use them on an Endo 3 and its derivatives. It's a high-flow nozzle and therefore currently only comes in sizes starting from 0.6mm up to 1.8mm, though I would like to see a 0.4mm variant as well. The Bontech CHT is made from brass with a nickel coating that protects against corrosion and makes the surfaces less sticky to plastic, but is not as wear resistant as hardened steel, for example, and is therefore not suitable for your carbon fiber materials. I was happy to see that it's, at least in my opinion, very reasonably priced at 20 bucks, so won't break the bank. Before we cut one open and try to figure out how it looks on the inside and gets manufactured, let's see how it performs and benchmark it against a standard V6 nozzle and, I think way more interestingly, an E3D volcano. For our first performance test, I've compared the 0.6mm variants. To make the tests as comparable as possible, I've done them all on the same E3D Himera, using the same heater cartridge, thermistor, and for both the V6 as well as the Volcano, use silicon socks for insulation. The extrusion test is really simple, and I basically just tell the extruder to feed 200mm of filament and weigh the extruded spiral of material. I then gradually increase the extrusion speed. At some point, the hot end won't be able to properly melt the material anymore, which results in more back pressure and more slip in the extruder gears, which I can measure with my scale. Just to give you an idea what normal melt rates are, take a look at these examples. With normal prints, using a standard 0.4mm nozzle, at 0.15mm layers, we're mostly printing at around 5 cubic millimeters a second or less. Using a 0.6mm nozzle with thicker 0.35mm layers, we max out at around 15 cubic millimeters a second, because this is often the limit of a normal extrusion system, so profiles are tuned for that. If you want to effectively use even bigger nozzles or go faster, higher flow extrusion systems are necessary. So let's get to the test. I first benchmarked the reference, a 0.6mm V6 nozzle. As just said, with a standard setup, we can usually go up to 15 cubic millimeters a second extrusion rate, which I again confirmed by this test. At that point, we already under extrude by 5%. Anything more and the extruder will start severely stripping and skipping. At 20 cubic millimeters a second, the results are unusable anymore with 25% of under extrusion. Let's compare that to the standard high flow setup from E3D, the Volcano, which significantly increases the length of the melt zone. Using this setup, we can basically double the extrusion rate and under extrude around 5% at 30 cubic millimeters a second, after which point things get really bad and unstable. Let's now change back to the standard length heater block and install the Bontech CHT nozzle. 15 and even 20 cubic millimeters a second didn't seem to be a problem, and we still get perfect flow. At 30 cubic millimeters a second, which was the limit for the Volcano setup, we can see the curve is slightly getting worse, but we are still only under extruding by 2%. At 40 cubic millimeters a second, we're just reaching the 5% under extrusion limit and are this way 33% better than the Volcano and almost 200% better than our standard V6 nozzle, which is unbelievable. If we go even higher, we can clearly see that we have reached the limit of the CHT, but man, better performance than the Volcano hotend at the size of a V6 nozzle. I also did the same test with a 1mm nozzle, which restricts the flow less and allows the Volcano to be usable up to 45 cubic millimeters a second, though the CHT 1mm performed like a champ up to 60 cubic millimeters a second and only started skipping at 90 cubic millimeters a second, which is probably more than you will ever need. Okay, so where do we continue now? Well, to better understand how the nozzle is manufactured and how it looks on the inside, I of course had to sacrifice a brand new one and cut it open on my CNC router. This nicely shows the yellowish brass-based material with the nickel coating on the outside, and we get an idea how they probably manufacture the unique geometry. Instead of one straight bore, they drill three times at an angle, which all terminate at the same point. I assume they first pilot drill with a bigger bit to create the sharp edge and then use a 0.2mm drill bit for the material channels. Really clever design, and I bet tricky to manufacture at this size if you're not careful. The thing that surprises me at first, but gets clearer if you take a look at my reverse engineered CAD model, is that the core, for which the C in CHT stands, is way smaller than one might expect and looks more like a blade that splits the material rather than significantly contributing to the heating of the material. As cruel as it might be for some, but I actually drilled out the divider on one of the nozzles and tested it. The results showed that it still performed way better than a standard nozzle, but has a significantly worse performance at the higher melt rates compared to the unmodified one, and even slightly falls short of the Volcano. So the filament splitter significantly contributes to the performance, but the other, maybe even more important and smart design of the CHT, is the increase in the heating surface by the cloverleaf shape that the three bores generate. A single circle is just a physically worse choice for heating something, because it has the smallest circumference compared to the area. Any deviation from that is better, though a circular hole is obviously the easiest to manufacture. Secondly, since plastics are such a bad conductor of heat, the distance from where you heat to the center of the material is also crucial, which is smaller with a claw relief shape compared to a circle. Having the heating core in at least part of the nozzle makes that even better, and due to the sharp edges, it also shouldn't constrain flow too much. And then there is the overall conical shape of the material channel, which I can't fully judge, but might also lower flow resistance and gradually decrease the distance from the hot walls to the center of the material. Overall, a top-notch design, which also shows in the more than impressive melting performance. But how does the design with the melt splitter and the undercut at the heat break do in a realistic printing scenario where you have retractions and travel moves? The retraction and stringing test printed with the 0.6mm nozzle looked very comparable, and even with a high amount of retracts, there didn't seem to be any clogging due to the CHT shape. Bigger nozzles have the tendency to string more, and the amount I'm seeing seems to be reasonable. My own mini-me and a 200% scaled up Marvin looked almost indistinguishable, with even a bit better overhangs using the Bontech nozzle. The other prints that I did with the 0.6 and the 1.4mm CHT nozzle turned out really well. My 200% mini-me took an hour to print with extrusion rates up to 40 cubic millimeters a second. The print looks great, just the amount of cooling that the Prusa provides is the bottleneck at some point, and the layers doesn't properly solidify before the next one is printed on top. I first had failures at higher extrusion rates on the 300% Benchy due to thermal runaway, but adding a silicone sock fixed that. Just by doing the maths, the 40 watts of the heater is plenty to melt that amount of material. There were some areas with a bit of under extrusion at 40 cubic millimeters a second, but I'm certain that even 30 or 35 cubic millimeters a second would have worked well with the Prusa extrusion system. Cold pulling a CHT nozzle for cleaning purposes is possible, yet I only managed to do it once, though I carefully burned out one of the nozzles successfully, but I don't recommend it because I'm not sure if that might chip the nickel coating. So, will this become the new standard of how 3D printing nozzles will look? I'm quite sure no. For once, there's additional effort and precision necessary during manufacturing, and not everyone will need the additional performance. The more striking argument, though, is the patent behind the technology that Bontech, in this case, licensed from 3D Solex. I linked the patent below if you're interested, which was granted in 2019. It covers various techniques that can be used to improve the melting rate of a nozzle by increasing surface area and heating the material from the center. I'm not a patent expert, and I don't know if there might even have been prior art on the RepRap forums. On the one hand, I think it's a legitimate invention that ended up in an improved product, so deserves some kind of protection and credit. On the other hand, I find it kind of sad that this now blocks other companies for the next 20 years of implementing something similar in, for example, a wear-resistant high-flow nozzle. Still, the inventor seems to at least be kind of open to licensing the technology. Another way is trying to work around patents that often sparks creativity in engineers, so maybe even you have an idea to improve on it. In summary, I can only say that I'm hugely impressed by the performance of Bontech's CHT nozzle, and the 30% increase in flow rate that they advertise is seriously the minimum I think you can expect. Even though they sent me the nozzles free of charge, I don't get paid, or were they able to review the video. The numbers and the print results objectively show that these nozzles are a serious improvement to what we used in the past and renders, in my opinion, at least for the moment, many high flow hot ends obsolete, because you can get similar performance by just switching out a nozzle. Additionally, the decrease in length and lower mass are very interesting for high speed printing. That said, not everyone currently has the need for this style of nozzle, especially since they are currently only available starting from 0.6mm upwards. Bontech, I hope you're listening, but I really want a 0.4mm variant for fast and detailed printing, and I'm sure I'm not the only one. Since extrusion performance is also depending on your feeder, don't expect the same results when changing the nozzle on a standard Ender 3. Still, for anyone who is looking for a simple solution to easily print faster, and especially with bigger nozzles, these $20 will be so well spent. Let me know in the comments what you think about these new nozzles, and if you ever used one, what was your experience? Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring part of this video. If you want to make yourself a beautiful website, then start a free trial at squarespace.com/cnckitchen and use code cnckitchen for 10% off your first purchase. Also, thank you for watching. I hope you found this review interesting. If you want to support my work, consider becoming a patron or a YouTube member and check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye. That I'm hugely impressed by the Performance.